going to be chaotic per usual. To all of my fuzzy friends that just got into the room, I will be involving all the fursuiters, but we're gonna go over a couple educational points first so that you can try and get something out of this panel before it just descends into chaos and laughter. So with that, I have a couple more fursuiters that will be joining me in a moment. I saw that, Hunter. You dabbed. You owe the bucket a dollar. So, to introduce you to my panel of fursuit helpers, everybody, this is the adorable, has participated in literally every single one of these panels that I have ever run, the amazing Chipper! Yeah! Over here we have one heck of a cool dragon, loves pineapple, not that pineapple, but loves pineapple and that pineapple. We have the amazing Blazin! Oh, he's got a pineapple backpack. That's everything. Next up, we have an amazing guy, guest of honor of Pine Fur Con, a flippity flappity bird, it's Adler the Eagle! Wow! And next up, we have another person who is no stranger to this panel, MOSFET's Tail! No, for real, we have the very bouncy, the very adorable, the very silent suitor, except for the bell that's very not silent and annoying. It's MOSFET! I love you. Your bell is wonderful. Just kidding. No, I love you. And next up we have the very yellow, the very huggable, the very adorable, it's Pineapple! So cute, so cute. And finally we have something that shouldn't even be possible. Somehow, some way, in some kid's bedroom, a plushie came to life and walks around and does athletic things like sprinting in the fursuit games despite being a massive stuffed animal. Give it up for Hugwoof! Awesome. So now that you know all of them, my name is Gale. This is Fursuiting 101. It's gonna be a good time. We're gonna go over fursuiting performance and what it's like to, you know, act as one of these fluffy characters. This is not gonna get into maintenance or cleaning or building or traveling with your fursuit or anything like that. There are panels at this con about that type of stuff and at any other con you're gonna go to. I also highly suggest, if you're looking for information on any of those things, to check out Matrices. She's a fursuit maker, and she has a to-do guide on anything you could possibly think of for a fursuit. So with that, we are going to get started, and also I'm gonna pull up Strobes, who's one of my other people, to come up here, because I need you, so that I can introduce you. Everybody, it's the dancing, wiggling his butt, Strobes! Awesome, awesome. All right. So, with that, could my fursuiters come stand out here on the floor, facing the audience? You can face the sides, you can face the front, wherever you want to front, spread out. All right. So, my lovely fursuiters. Wow. None of this is correct. Blazin is correct. Okay, with that, fursuiters, if you can face the audience.
Oh.
Face the audience, not over here. Strobes, go over there. Face the audience. The first thing we're gonna talk about is the fact that with fursuiters, Strobes, what are you doing with that mic? Okay, you're pantomiming me. The first thing we're gonna talk about is how when you have a fursuit, one of the big things is you have impaired vision when you're in fursuit. So we're gonna talk about everybody's line of sight. So what I want the fursuiters to do is I want the fursuiters to show us what their peripheral line of sight is. So they're gonna take their arms and outstretch them and start bringing them in towards their muzzles or beaks until they can see their arms or their hands. And that's gonna show us the line of sight vision for these fursuits. So, now, you'll see that it varies a lot, and that's because every maker has a different design to their eyes. Hogwolf has huge eyes, and thus has a lot more line of sight, which is good, because Hogwolf needs to be able to see who they're gonna hug. That's very important. Pineapple. Pineapple has 3D eyes. They're inset, but they're also very large. So again, huge range of sight, which is again great because hugging. Strobes. Strobes is a Gale Costumes fursuiter, and again, has a great range of sight because of where they're placed on the head. Stop. Stop it. Mossbat, what's your line of sight like? You can see, yes, you can, with your eyes. Hold your arms out, where can you see your arms? No, you're just looking. Just, can you see? Okay, so again, recessed eyes, 3D eyes, very big eyes, we can see super duper well. Super duper well. Again, Adler, recessed 3D eyes, so again, amazing line of sight. Blazin, I don't think you can see a T-pose. I don't think you can see that much. I think you're lying. Is that your range of vision? My God, does nobody have a bad range of vision? Okay, this is not a great example. Yeah, Heath, can you come up here for a second? Yeah, so Heath, what's your range of vision? Okay, so this is much more standard. A lot of fursuiters have a much tighter range of vision. So you just have to be aware that even though some fursuiters have amazing ranges of vision, thank you, Heath, that a lot of fursuiters, like Auntie, you have tear duct vision, so you really can only see in front of you. So keep that in mind when you are interacting with fursuiters, because you might be like, and they can't see you at all. So make sure you say their name, or if you don't know their name, like, hey, you know, the green dog, to get their attention. Don't like sneak up on a fursuiter. That's a bad time. That's a bad, what is happening? Oh my Lord, okay. This is just gonna descend into chaos very, very quickly. Hug, did you just run? Because it scares me when you run. I can't run and I'm just a person. You're incredible. Chipper! No! Mm-mm! You remember two years ago when the car picked up my drink and it went everywhere? Mm-mm, we're not doing that. Mm-mm, over here. What? I hate this panel so much! Okay, anyways, we're moving on to posing, okay? Fursuiters, get in a line! Get in a line! Blazin, right here. Adler, right here. Mossbat, right here. Great job. Pineapple, right here. Strobes, right there. Okay. Hug, this will take a step forward. Okay? And Chipar, you're good there. All right, let's talk about posing. Something that you're gonna inevitably be asked when you're in your fursuit is, can I get a picture? Okay? And when somebody says, can I get a picture? It's really not gonna be an exciting experience if you just stand there. Just standing there is not a fun pose. So, what we're gonna do is I'm gonna have our fursuiters pose in different ways. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come back here and we're gonna count 3, 2, 1 pose. And when we say pose, all of these fursuiters are gonna strike a pose like they're gonna be getting a beautiful photo of themselves. So stand normal for now. All right, audience. 3, 2, 1, pose. Okay, let's talk about the posing. Let's talk about it. So, we'll start over on this side this time. Blazin, he's giving me some dynamic action poses. He is bending his legs, he's leaning, he's pointing, he's like, you. I don't know if that's a threat. I don't know if he's just like, I like that direction. I don't know if he's telling me like, that's where we should go. but he's pointing. Adler is giving me some I'm a mascot moment where he's like, boom, I'm great, look at me, take my picture, that's what you asked for, so I'm posing for you. It's energetic, it's exciting, it's fun, this is a good pose, we like this pose. MOSFET is copying, he's copying someone else. He's just, MOSFET is giving us a dynamic pose. You can see that he is leaning, he's pointing. We don't know if it is a threat, or perhaps he's just pointing somewhere, trying to get us to look behind us, where a giant monster is approaching. Thanks, Moss. Ooh, Pineapple's giving us some modeling. He's like, girl, look at me. Look at my hips. Look at my thighs. Look at my paws. I'm Pineapple, and I'm sassy. Look at that. That is a nice pose. Ooh, Strobe's doing a similar thing. He's like, look at my body. You have to look at it, because my suit is very tight. Very tight. So he's giving us I was gonna say a word, but then there's kids. So he's giving us some sass. Hug. Hug Wolf is just posing because he wants a hug.
Because if he doesn't get a hug, he gets really upset at it. And so you just gotta get a hug. I currently can't wall, so my mouth is currently
stuck open. Thanks, Hug. That was good. You gotta hug this guy. Oh, and Chipper's doing something that's great. Chipper is not standing. He has used a different level. We hear that all the time in dance comps. Use levels. But it's also great for photos because you get this cute, adorable pose of him on the floor, like, I'm adorable. Look how cute I am. I've got my pawsies up. And it gives a nice dynamic pose. It's something different. It's going to make the photographer be like, oh, I haven't seen that, that's so cute. And they're gonna get a nice picture of their fursuit that's not just them standing. So very nice. All right, fursuiters, and all of you creeping in the background, I see you. I'm aware, do you wanna come pose? Okay, do whatever you want, all of the Boston furs. All right, so, and Jib. All right, so fursuiters, I challenge you this time to do another pose, but either in a different level. Very high up, mid, or on the ground for all of you, and Chipper, not on the ground for you. So, we're gonna do a different pose. Audience, you're gonna count with me, and you're gonna actually count with me this time, because otherwise it seems lame. We're gonna go 3, 2, 1, pose! That's a lot! A lot is happening! Wow! I'm gonna talk about Strobe's last, so he has to keep that pose. Alright, so, Chipper, as we said, different pose. He had done a floor pose earlier, so now he's doing a standing pose. He's giving me some like martial art posies. He could, ooh, look at you. He's a fighting werewolf. Hug Wolf is like, I have fallen and I cannot get up. Cute pose, most staffers, like the staffer in me, would walk by and be like, gee, I wonder if they're just posing or if they're dead. But real cute either way, so. Strobes is giving me, maybe some like, don't do that! Other than that, Strobes is giving me some like civil engineering, I like bridges. Very nice. London Bridge has fallen down on one side. Pineapple is giving me some hunched over, rawr!
Hold on, I'm too cute.
Oh wait, it's gonna get better. It's gonna get better. Ooh! He's giving me spooky, scary eyes. Let's take a quick moment, to talk about how Pineapple's a more for less suitor, which means he has poseable eyebrows. Do not go up to a more for less suitor or another suitor with poseable things and start posing them for them. That's not okay. People have had their eyelids broken, they've had fur ripped off because people don't know how to do it. So please be respectful. If you see a suitor like this and you're like, oh, I would love like a picture of you with the angry face, they're more than likely going to say, oh yeah, sure, let me fix that for you. So please don't grab people's eyebrows. I'm sorry, I tried to get to you fast, but I had to talk about the eyebrows. Adler was giving us some dabbing. And I hate it. You know what is better than dabbing? Instead of dabbing, do the Usain Bolt. Same, you can do the same thing with your arms, but it's not dabbing, so I don't hate it. So do the Usain Bolt, okay? For the two people in here that follow sports. Yeah. And then we have some Zen posing, like we at yoga class. We're not sure if he's just chilling. We're not sure if he's in like just relaxation headspace, or if he's in a, oh, you are bad. Or if he's just gonna come out and attack us, but instead he was a distraction so that someone else could attack me. Back here, we have something great. We got a nice couples pose here, being cute. Ferric and Little Fen being adorable, being a cute couple. And Sherpy coming in like, also notice me. Also notice me, I'm here too. So here I am, I'm posing, I'm being awesome. Up here we have Mossfet and Jib recreating their video from a few months ago where they got into a fight in a video battle. Maybe don't do this one if you're like, maybe don't do this one because like you can break things or yourselves. But this one's fun, fun pose, very fun pose. And then Mocha has also climbed up onto the furniture to show you that she is not a tame fox and she will pounce.
No.
She's in the pouncing pose. In the pouncing pose. Okay, neat, awesome. So, the next thing we're gonna do is I need all of my fursuiters to kind of gather like in a line. So someone's gonna stand here. Okay. And then you're gonna start wrapping the line this way because we're gonna talk about fursuit walking. We're having a catwalk, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a catwalk. All right, so get into a line formation. A line formation. If you can't get back there and you just bunch up over here, that's fine. We're just gonna leave the majority of this space so that the fursuiters can like, you're gonna, fursuiters, you're gonna walk over here, and then you're gonna walk this way and back around. None of you are paying attention. Blazin, thanks for paying attention. Thanks for paying attention. What a pal, what a friend. Okay, so we're gonna do the walk. And Chipper, what are you doing? Chipper, you are being part of the audience. Fun, that's fun. Okay, don't know why, but so Hogwolf is gonna be our first walker. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna be talking about how when you're in fursuit, this isn't very exciting, okay? I might walk from point A to point B just walking, but that's not super thrilling. You as your character can do very, very little things while you walk that will define your character, okay? And if I could get Dushep to join that lineup too, we're gonna have me, but not me, also participate. So, Hogwolf, how do you walk in character from point A to point B? Oh, I come over here, that's step one. Oh. I don't know why I had to come over here for that, but this is oh so cute. Wait, oh my god, no, oh no, oh no, oh, 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 it got terrifying, really cute, because it was really adorable, and then I was scared. Whew. Okay, well, now that my heart is racing, I'm gonna sit elsewhere, I'm sit in this corner, away from everything, and Strobes is gonna show us how he walks from point A to point B in character. Yeah, he's waving, he's blowing kisses, he's actually waving, as in the dance move, and he's doing it, he's killing it. Great job, Strobe! Nice. Oh, wow, that was a lot. That was a very adventurous way to go from point A to point B. All right, Adler. How do you walk in character from point A to point B? Oh, okay, yeah. Whoa. Very bird. That was very bird-like. Very bird. It's like, whoa, what's happening? Whoa. Hey, I'm a bird. I'm okay. I don't like the ground. Because Adler is an eagle and likes to travel by flight. Yeah, so on the ground, Adler's like, whoa, what is the ground? Whoa! That's crazy. Okay, so Blazin, how do you walk in character from point A to point B? Ooh, giving us a little sass, a little confidence. Yeah, feeling yourself, yeah. See, just walking with confidence actually makes it so much more interesting to get from point A to point B. Mosfet, how do you walk from point A to point B?
I'll give you a hug. I'm gonna go for lunch.
And this is why you're always sweaty! But as you can see, Mosfet walking from point A to point B is very energetic, very silly, very nonsensical, very fun, and very attention-grabbing. You would see that in the lobby and you'd be like, wow, what's happening over there? Oh, he's gone! He left! Point B is elsewhere. Well, that's fun. Wow. Okay, well, with that, Chirpy Cheetah, how do you walk from point A to point B? Yeah. Yeah, he's sniffing. I think he found it. Ah, he found the cute thing. Yay, now he's happy. Sniffing and snooping like a happy cheetah. Nice job, Chirpy. Oh, and we all make a fur pile. All right, Ferric with the Bruins jersey. Yeah. How do we walk from point A to point B? Yeah, he's strutting. He's strong. He's like a Bruins rule. And he's like, yo, I see my buddy Mac out there. He likes the Bruins too. And Boston Sports. I'm like, yeah, what's up? Pound it. Yeah. Yeah, that's a nice cool walk. Oh, and then he goes and kisses his soon-to-be wife. Oh, it's so cute. Yeah, claps for almost married. All right, now we got my best friend in the whole world. It's Little Fen. Little Fen, the tiny Fennec. How do you walk from point A to point B? Oh, you small. You are so small, you walk small. Oh, it's so cute. Oh, what's happening? Oh, I get a kiss. Oh, I wish everybody walked like that. That's good. I like that. Oh, and then Hug Wolf is moving somewhere. Oh, he's doing a sit. I have fur in my mouth. What are you doing? Okay. I don't trust you. All right, we got Jib. Jib Cody is here, and he's going to show us how he walks from point A to point B. Yeah, he's energetic. He's wild. He's living his best life. He is truly a living animation. He is just walking around. He's like, oh, I see Mosfet, and I'm mad about seeing Mosfet. I'm going to walk away. I'm looking at you, but I'm walking away. I'm better than that. Oh, Jesus. Okay, well, nice and comfortable. Okay, even closer. Pineapple, how do you walk from point A to point B? Whoa, he's a monster. It's a pineapple monster. I this monster must have jumped out of one of the monster films from Pineapple's Monster Films. Oh my God, we're gonna die. It's gonna be so sweet and delicious though. Okay, so we have a monster walk, a big, scary, thigh-thundering monster walk. All right, next up we have Mocha. Mocha, how do you walk from point A to point B? Oh, like a cute fox, a happy cute fox. Oh, she's shy. Oh, she's posing. She's like, oh, I'm so shy, but I'm gonna blow kisses and be like, I'm so cute. Excuse you, strobes. Oh, this is great. If all the fursuiters can just keep kissing me and maybe not put their dirty indoor paws or outdoor paws on my head. disgusting. I showered before this, and now this is happening. All right, Chipper, how do you walk from point A to point B? Very slowly. Gets distracted. Oh, has realized he's a wolf. Oh, is now going to feral walk because he came to the realization that he is, in fact, a wolf. Yeah, and then he's gonna blow kisses, because that's what wolves do in the wild. Wolves squawk feral and then stand up anthro and blow kisses. That's a natural history fact right there. That's how that works. All right, Dooship, how do you walk from point A to point B? Yeah, he's a cool dude. He's strutting. He's like, ooh, he's dancing. He's dancing. Yeah, he's a dancey dog. Yeah, that was, wow. There's a lot happening on my back. Okay, neat. So I see some of my friends have joined the room. Aura, and I ate too much pasta, and KG, and Leon, and Doral. Would you guys like to walk from point A to point B? Yeah, come on up. Come on up and walk from point A to point B.
I have a question.
Yeah, Pineapple has a question.
Is any of this going to be on the test?
This will all be on the test, yes.
Okay.
You have to write back word for word exactly how everybody walked. Oh my god, Aura's feet are so big that they're just going to take out all of the AV equipment.
I'm a good walker.
You're a good walker. All right, Aura is walking from point A to point B and is always he's having a tight, he's good walking.
I did it.
And Hug found exactly what he wanted to find. Oh, and then he left. Oh no, Aura.
What?
You need to compare paw size.
Oh.
Whoa.
Oh.
You can't do
that. Oh, that's pretty close.
Manhole covers.
They are manhole covers. All right, I love that. Aura, come sit with us. Come sit with us. All right. Next up, we have I Ate Too Much Pasta, which is quite the name for a fursuit.
I made too much pasta.
Sorry. All right, how does I Made Too Much Pasta walk from point A to point B? Oh, yes. A very effective way to get from point A to point B while also volunteering to clean the hotel floors. Nice. That's some good walking. Ooh.
Whoa.
Nice.
Ow.
Good job, I made too much pasta. All right. Oh, okay. All right. That's okay. How about you, KG? Mm. KG, how do you walk from point A to point B?
Well, since it's the 70s, how do they walk in the 70s?
That's true. It's the 70s. Yeah. Yeah, he's strutting. He's strutting. He got somewhere to go. Oh! Oh! He know what's up. I love it. Keep on grooving. You go wherever you want, KG. You go wherever.
Hi.
All right. Leon, how do you, Jackalman, walk from point A to point B?
I didn't think this through all the way.
You didn't study.
I'm going to be a supermodel today, though.
Okay, I love it. Supermodel. Yeah, he's strutting, looking fabulous. Post the audience. Yeah. Ooh, yeah. RuPaul, killing it. Mm. Yeah. Nice. Oh, right, we have... Wow, that's an outfit, Derek. Wow. We got the jock that also wants to cheer. Derek, how do you walk from point A to point B? Skipping! Aww. That's everything. Oh my god. Okay, so with that, now, audience, were those very interesting ways to walk from point A to point B?
Yeah.
Was all of those, even the more subtle ones, still very fun ways and more imaginative than just walking?
Yes.
So it's something to think about when you're walking around in fursuit. Even if you do something very, very small to change it up, do that, and you'll add so much flavor to your fursuiting performance, okay? So, stop that, Chipper. Stop that. Don't touch that, that's expensive and could fall on you. No! I'm sorry, Hawk. I'm sorry. No, stop. Stop. Don't touch it. AV, don't look up here. All right. Let's see. What's next on my list? What's next on my list? What's next on my list? How much time do we have? All right, 12:33. We're doing it. We're doing it. Cool. We're walking. We're posing. Awesome. Emotion time. All right. Let's talk about conveying emotion in fursuits. If all of my fursuiters could either stand up on the stage or spread out around the dance floor, facing all sides of the room, good job. Very effective spreading. Oh, not that didn't sound good. Cut that out. Didn't say that. All right. So just so all of my fursuit friends in the audience that want to participate know, after we do a couple of motions, we're going to invite other fursuiters up, and we're going to be doing some little acting challenges, okay? So my fursuiters that are up here hanging out, let's go through some basic emotions, okay? So I want everybody to stand still and boring and pretend like you are a boring human. They're ready. They're ready over here in the audience. They're ready. All right. Now, I want you to convey without words or sound, just by like posing and acting, I want you to convey the emotion happy. You're happy. You're happy. You're happy. You're so happy. You're so happy. Oh my God, you're so happy. I see people are wiggling. People are waving their hands, people are shaking their tails, people are jumping up and down on furniture and potentially threatening their lives. People are lifting chairs up and down excitedly and being strange. People are moving their arms about. People are like nodding to each other like, yeah, man, I am just so ding-dang happy right now. And Moffat and Jib are so happy they're killing each other. And Shipper is so happy to be here with me. Oh, are you just trying to eat the microphone? No. Back out there. Back. All right, so audience, did we feel like all the fursuiters were very easily conveying without words being happy? Yep, did you see how a lot of them did very similar things to convey the happiness? Yeah, so it's one of those things, this is all stuff like if you are soon getting your fursuit or you just got your fursuit, you can practice in the mirror or record yourself and look back and be like, oh, if I look at this as just a normal person, do I get the feeling that I'm trying to emote? So, now I need all of my fursuiters to return to being boring. Boring. All right. Just boring. Just, okay. And now, I need my fursuiters up here to convey the emotion sad. Sad. They're sad. They're so sad. There's no fans open and available in the headless lounge. They're sad about it. Nobody has given them pets. They're so upset. They've been at this con 3 gosh darn days and they haven't gotten any snuggles. They're so sad. It's a sad time. They've been thinking about getting a video game and they didn't get it, and Adler is so sad his hat came off. And maybe they wanted ice cream and they didn't get ice cream. Sad. I know. That's sad. That's depressing. Like when you see that ice cream truck and you're at work and you're like, God, I wanted ice cream. That happens all the time where I work. Okay, so what are our fursuiters doing to convey sad? We have a lot of them covering their face. I'm so sad right now. We have a lot of them looking down, a lot of them very, very scrunched in together. A lot of them are on the floor. A lot of them have just given up and fallen over. A lot of them have moved themselves away from the situation, faced their back to us. Derek has completely completely melted. Completely melted. Oh, Leon has bendable ears. So he's bending his ears over his eyes, like, oh, I'm so sad right now. These two are being sad together, in camaraderie. And Duchef is so mad that they lost the lacrosse game. He's so sad about it. Okay, fursuiters, stop being sad. I hate seeing sad fursuiters. But, audience, you agree? Another very easy to convey emotion just by simple things, not even having to say or do anything. That's great. Everybody's happy again. Everybody's happy again. All right, so next emotion. This one is an emotion for those that are old enough to have this emotion. It's drunk. You're all drunk. Everybody's drunk. Everybody had too much drink. Everybody's drinky. Little drinky. If you're a kid, you had too much soda. Ooh, too much soda for the kids. Too much root beer. Too much ginger ale. Ooh. You got that sugar. This is the hangover after the sugar rush. Yeah, the crash. Who's got a chair? Who has a chair? Stop! You're drunk. You're not destructive. Not destructive. Oh my god, Pineapple's face. Pineapple's eyebrows right now are everything I've ever wanted.
You don't know me.
Oh my god, why? No, not again! Jim, Cody. Oh, these four have started to sing and dance together. They're from, they're from Boston. Because they're like, the Red Sox won again! Shipping up to Boston!
The World Series! I love you guys, you know that? You guys are the best!
Mac, are you just asleep? I just wanted to say that Mac's not even up here, and he was like, oh, drunk? I fall asleep. Nailed it. These guys are like, I love you, man. Love you, man. And MOSFET's over here because MOSFET doesn't drink. He's a designated driver and he's mad about everybody else. All right, so now that our fursuiters are all sufficiently wasted. Okay, all right. Well, I guess we'll do tired next. Everybody's tired. Oh no! Jim! Jim! Not again! No! My exposed foot! My foot is exposed! My foot is exposed!
What is
the mic even working anymore? I don't know!
It is, yes.
I'm so far down on the ground.
It's just funny. Are you
gonna sell those? That's my foot! Stop that! It's exposed! Stop! That tickles! No! I said tired, not cruddy human beings! Oh! You know, I don't want that in my face. That's my sock! Oh, yuck. Yuck, I'm so happy that I've only worn those for like 2 hours so far. Oh my god. Okay. Hey, audience! What is an emotion we should have the first to do next before we get everybody else up here? Thank you. Hey, okay. We'll save that one. Where? Where are my articles of clothing? Where's my socks? Jim! Those aren't for your hands! Mad about everything. Now I'm walking barefoot on the con floor. It's disgusting.
How do you think we feel? I'm
gonna have con crud on my feet. Disgusting. At least I painted my nails. You never know. Oh, there. Now I don't have to touch the floor. I understand. Oh, I don't trust you. All right, I need you guys to convey the emotion. Angry! I'm angry about my shoes being so close, but yet so far. No, that's not fair, that's bullying! No, I'm in the chute. No.
This is terrible.
Stop that! Oh my god, no. All right, angry. What are they all doing for angry? Shout it out, audience. What are they doing to convey angry? Hitting stuff. This is maybe not one to do in con space. And disco dancing. You know, when you're really angry in the 70s, you just went to the disco and you went hard. Alright, I have a sock. Can I have that? I swear to God, Mac. Stop! Alright, I guess I won't. Audience, have we at least taken away something from this panel that when you're in fursuit, have fun. You're a giant animal. Act. Be energetic. Be big. Be silly. Guys, the world is too serious. This is your chance to have fun. Be silly, be a kid again, or just still be a kid. Many of you are still kids. I'm jealous of you. So yeah. Thank you so much for coming to Fursuiting 101. If you enjoy this panel, I'll be doing it again at every time. Thank you everybody for coming. Thank you so much to our fursuiters for sweating and being very warm throughout this whole performance. I need to go sprint upstairs and get into fursuit for the parade. Woo!